Good morning, students. Students of 10th standard. I think last time I have explained the first lesson. A wrong man in paradise. And along with that, I had given homework assignment to write question answers, to underline the sentences. Also, I had given phrasal sentences to use them in sentences of your own. Thinking that you might have done, this is 10th standard. The great responsibility is on you, and you have to overcome your own difficulties. Now, today I am dealing with one poem. The poem I have taken here, poem number one, "To a Pair of Sarus Cranes," written by Manmohan Singh. Now look to the pre-reading activity. Open your books, textbooks, come to the poem site, and you start the first poem. See the first poem. The pre-reading activity. "The greatness of a nation and moral progress can be judged by the way its animals are treated." Well, if you go to a nation or a new country or a new village, at least I will go down here, let us roam in our own country, you must know how the village is. This sentence is said by Mahatma Gandhiji, "The greatness of a nation and moral progress can be judged by the way its animals are treated." How you treat the animal, how much sympathy you have towards animal, on that we can judge the progress of the country, progress of the nation, and greatness of the nation, how great the people are. Greatness never lies in killing the birds, in killing the animals. You have to show courtesy towards birds and animals. Mahatma Gandhi, how true is this statement? Let us see whether this statement is true. Discuss in pairs. You make your pairs there. Discuss this, whether the sentence quoted or said by Mahatma Gandhiji is a correct one, whether it is applicable. This all we have to judge. Now here, "The Pair of Sarus Cranes." To a pair of sarus cranes. Here, these two birds are flying in the sky early in the morning. Well, I will read the first para. "The male was shot as he necked to pull the reluctant sun out from the rim of horizon." A hunter came. The birds are flying in the sky. Hunter took his aim and he shot one of the birds. That is a male bird. Male and female both are flying in the sky. That's so that it is called a pair of sarus cranes. One is shot, that the male is shot. How the hunter picked the bird as he necked, he caught it by the neck. How? He has given one example: to pull the reluctant sun out from the rim of horizon. As sun is reluctant to rise, and we are pulling the sun out to come out of the horizon, in that manner, it was not the intention of the male bird to die, but it was just what we call a side, a murder, a gruesome murder we can call. The bird was shot dead, and the example is there. The reluctant sun is pulled out of the horizon. You might have understood this first para. Now, second para, she flew crying. She means who? The another bird which was alive, which was not shot, the companion of the male bird. Both the lovers are flying in the sky. One of the lovers, that is the male bird, is shot. Now, the female bird is crying just because the male bird is shot dead. As he was picked up, hands and jaws and a proud neck was humbled. So how the bird was picked? It was picked by its hands and jaws. Before, when it was alive, the neck of the bird was proud. Peacock is proud, what they call. Here saras, cranes, both are proud. The proud neck was humbled. It is oxymoron figure of speech. Proud and humble, two words are there. To lie like a dirty lilan in a coarse washing bag. How the bird was caught? By its, picked up by hands and jaws, and it was thrown in the washing bag, like washing bag, like dirty linen clothes, how they throw in the basket. In that manner he threw it in that bag. He picked up away, he threw it in that. No sympathy. Sympathy will not be there in the hunter, otherwise you would have not shot the bird. A loveless person, a heartless person. Now, the scene of female birds starts. She circled the sky. Now the female bird is encircling the sky in movements of grace over its graceful end. This was the end of the end of her lover. His life ended here. The killers went away and she returned to the death scene. Now the killers killed the bird, male bird, threw it in the bag, took it away cruelly. Now the female bird has come to the death scene where her husband had fallen, that is, the male bird had fallen dead. With grief that inscribed its intensity, see the grief, see the sadness. It was in a great intensity, it went on increasing in dots and fits, like the Morse code of bird sorrow. Now, Morse code is a symbolic language. Previously, in post office, telegraph messages used to be sent by dots and fits by Morse code. They used to beat that button, and just code words, one or two, I know what I will tell, didda, da, didda, didda, da, didda, and the graph used to give the words there. Here also, the bird is sending its cry in the sky like Morse code. Like the Morse code of bird sorrow, it is just transmitted to the air. See, the female bird is transmitting her grief in the sky through the air. Now, next para. With her beak, she kissed a few feathers. See the love. See the love of the female bird towards the male bird. Now this bird, fallen feathers have fallen here and there. Male birds fallen here and there. She is kissing them. See the love. This is love. This is the true love, I say. Pick the ones that wind had not taken away. Number of feathers were taken away by wind, but one or two had fallen there. She picked one of them in her beak and sat to hatch. She sat on that feather as if she is hatching the egg. The blood-stained feathers, the feathers of the bird, male bird, have fallen here and there. They are all blood-stained, colored with blood, into a toddling chick. So in a small chick, toddling chick, she has taken the feathers. Now, see, this is the tragic end, what we call, where both male and female die. Tragic stories you might have come across. Shakespeare has written Romeo and Juliet. In Punjab, Heer Ranjha is there. So many Soni Mahiwal tragic stories are there, where hero dies or hero heroine, both of them die. So see the tragic end. You have to read the tragic literature. So many films are also there. In Kannada, one Nagar Hamu is there, where both actor and actress dive up, go up top of the hill. From there, they dive down and they both of them die. This is the tragic end. Here also, the male bird died. Now see the tragic end of the other bird. A wave of the sea she had never seen. Wave of the sea. See, the poet has given example. Wave. The female bird had never seen the wave man, that is death. She has not seen the death. Came to her from far away. From far away this wave came and carried her to him. Means she too died in grief. And she was carried away to him. She went away beyond Hume's words, beyond the legends and fables of human love. This is all beyond the fables, legends and fables of human love. This is the end of the poem. Just because her companion died, she too died. Simply, she did not die. In grief, she died. Now, children, I think you might have understood this poem. I have explained it. Now, I will give a note on the poet. Manmohan Singh, an officer of the Indian Administrative Service, is a contemporary poet. He is also a poet. His poems have been published in number of magazines. His poems have come in number of magazines. This poem is chosen from his book entitled, means titled as Village Poems. He has made a book, he has written a book, Village Poems, and from that a pair of Saras Crane has been selected. Summary. I will just explain in detail. To a Pair of Saras Cranes is a touching poem written by Manmohan Singh. It is a touching poem We have to read this poem with heavy heart and wet eyes. The poem deals with the grief of the female bird which dies pining away for its mate which had been shot dead by cruel hunters. See the pricking of her heart, what pricks in her heart. The poet conveys the heartlessness of the hunters, see, cruel hunters, and the grief of the female bird through powerful imagery. In the first place, the bird was shot when its beak was immersed in water in a playful attempt to pull out the sun. As if he is pulling out the sun, in that manner he has picked up the bird, that is the shot bird, that seemed reluctant to rise, as if the sun is unwilling to rise from its horizon. There somebody is forcing it to rise. That the beauty of the scene didn't stop the hunters from killing it brings out their cruelty. It shows the cruelty of the hunters. To make matters worse, they do not treat the bird with dignity. They do not treat the birds with dignity because they are hunters. After it has been shot down, even after when they have shot down, they have not shown sympathy. The simile used to show the way the bird was picked, see, the like the linen cloth in a dirty coarse basket, picked up by its hand and jaws and dumped like dirty linen in a coarse wash bag. In a coarse wash bag it has been dumped. Further reflects the callousness of the hunters. See the cruelty of the hunters. The Saras cranes which mate for life made it so much harder for the female bird to accept the loss of her partner. But it is uncompensated matter, cannot be compensated by any means. We see her returning to the scene after the hunters had left. And when the hunters go away, her scene starts, circling the sky over the sands of death and whining painfully with sounds resembling, crying with great sounds. The sounds of the Morse code, like the sounds of the Morse code words, when she finally spotted a feather or two, she is seen kissing them. The bird, female bird, is seen kissing the feathers, sitting over them as if to hatch them and bring her partner back to life. Because the female bird knows when she sits on the eggs, if she hatches, the baby bird will come away. Now she is trying, sitting on the feathers, to hatch them and bring her partner back to life. When those doesn't hatch to become a chick, she cannot bring out the chick. We see her pinning away and die. We see her dying. A wave which the least expected came in the transported her away to another land beyond human reach. Now a wave of season, the death comes to her and the death carries away beyond human reach. Here the wave stands for the death. Here the wave, I told you, the sea wave stands for the death itself, which relieved the female bird of its grief, which has brought her out of the grief. Now this is what I have explained you all in this lesson, in this poem. Now what you have to do, you go on writing the summary what I have given here, and afterwards you write question answers, reference to context lines may be there, you go underline the lines and try to answer the questions. This is for your homework assignment. Thank you. Thank you very much.